casts. I love casts. I love casts. I love submitting casts.
Hello, everyone. In this video, we're going to be discussing the ins and outs of casts. You'll learn the who, the what, the when, the why, and of course the how of casti, which is of course the plural of cast. Today I'm joined by my wonderful co-stars, Vivian Nodland and Elijah Dastrup. So just throw out your cast handbook, cast time. Oh, we're gonna learn about cast.
I love
cast.
CAS is an acronym that stands for Creativity, Activity, and Service. Creativity is fairly self-explanatory and can be kind of exploited because anything can be creative if you try hard enough. Activity is also fairly simple. It's not an activity like puzzles, but it has to be active. This can be running, biking, or doing any sort of sport. And finally, service. This can be things like helping out at soup kitchens, raising money for charity, or cleaning up a park. Here are 50 experiences generated by ChatGPT. Pause the video to steal them. I don't care.
I wake up and I cast. I fall asleep, I cast.
CAS is unfortunately the brainchild of our European IB overlords, so it has some interesting requirements. One, your supervisor has to be older and wiser than you. This can be a family friend, an event organizer, or an expert in whatever you're doing. There has to be an imbalance of power. Your 18-year-old friend Kyle doesn't count. Get out of here, Kyle! Your parents can be your CAS supervisor, especially for more personal experiences, but you cannot use them for every experience. We've found that you can probably get away with like 30% of your experiences being with them. But seriously, avoid it if you can. Remember that you need your supervisor's email or phone number in order for them to fill out the online CAS form, or they can fill it out on paper. Ask your local IB coordinator for a paper form today.
2. Your experience has to work in at least one CAS learning outcome. These include increased awareness for areas of strength and growth.
Get better at doing something.
Undertake challenges and develop skills.
Do something challenging and new.
Plan and initiate activities.
Plan something out. Demonstrate some forethought.
Work collaboratively with others.
Talk to other humans.
Show perseverance and commitment in activities.
Don't give up on hard stuff.
Engage with issues of global importance.
Care about the environment and other issues that are affecting the world.
Consider the ethical implications of actions.
This is the hardest one. You need to think about how your actions and decisions affect the people and places around you. One example is when I filled out the survey for IB and called it a service CAS, and one of the questions involved AI. It was asking me how much I had used AI on my homework assignments. The survey was anonymous, and I wouldn't get in trouble for my answer, but I was still nervous. Do I lie and cover my tracks, or do I tell the truth and admit that I haven't written an essay myself since November of 2022? Decisions!
Side note. Overall, your experiences have to include a variety of learning outcomes, including number 7. So try to plan ahead a little and add as many of them to each experience as possible. For example, taking a hike with your friends can work for numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
3. You need to complete, on average, 2 to 3 CAS experiences per month. Chill. Deep breath. It's okay. One of the benefits of CAS is that you don't have to worry about reaching a certain hour quota. Let me repeat myself. You don't have to worry about how long each thing takes, only the amount of experiences that you have. But this comes with a caveat. You have to have a mix of short-term and long-term CAS experiences. For example, a short-term CAS experience would be taking a hike with your friends, but a long-term experience would be hiking 2 times a week for 3 weeks. Other long-term experiences can come from clubs and sports. Speaking of long-term CAS experiences,
The CAS project is basically just a long CAS experience with a couple extra requirements. You have to fill out a couple extra forms, there's a couple extra requirements, and it has to be collaborative. It also has to fit into the standard creativity, activity, service thing. The hard bit is that it has to take at least 1 month from planning till completion. But this isn't actually that bad. You can, for example, plan an event for an entire month, only for the event to last 1 day. Would you believe it? The video you are watching right now is actually the result of a CAS project! Would you believe it? Wow!
I'm full of CAS energy.
Side note, this video was made in February of 2024, so if things look a little bit different in ManageBack, don't freak out. All right, get to manageback.com. And if you don't know how to get here and you don't know how to log in, I can't help you. In the menu on the left, hit IB Programs Management. And if it's not already open, hit CAS. And it's a big red, green, blue button. You can't miss it. Okay, on the top right, big orange button says Add CAS Experience. Click that. Welcome to the CAS Experience page. Let's start by choosing a color. Make it pretty. Name your experience something good. Remember, IB sees this. A French guy might see this. Click this little button if it's your CAS project. If it's not, don't click it. Choose your strand. If you choose service, then the type of service action, either direct, indirect, advocacy, or research. If you didn't choose the service, skip over this section. Next up, choose your approach. Ignore ongoing and choose school-based, community-based, or individual. Put in your start date and your end date. Technically, you have to plan each CAS experience out beforehand, but you know, sometimes after a dance, you get stuck cleaning up, even though you're not even in student council, and it shouldn't be your job, but your girlfriend who actually is in student council. Now time to dox your supervisor. Put in their name, their title, email, then write a super short description of your thing. Don't go too in-depth. Seriously, that's for your reflection later. Finally, choose which learning outcomes you want. Make sure this button is checked. Look over everything one last time and click Add CAS Experience.
Welcome to Will It CAS, the show where we challenge your CAS knowledge and teach you something along the way. Feel free to pause the video in between questions. Will It CAS! Participating in cooking a dish for your cooking club after school. Yes, this is a creativity cast in which you will have clear evidence of your participation. Babysitting your neighbor's kids every weekend for 14 an hour. No, you are earning money that you do not plan to donate. Creating a film for your IB film course. No, CAS cannot coincide with any other IB requirements. No double dipping. Volunteering with your church at Harvesters. Yes, this counts as a service to your community and does not have to do directly with any religious affiliations. Biking until you can get to 5 miles to build up your cycling endurance. Yes. This is an activity CAS in which you demonstrate gained skills and self-improvement. Learning how to skateboard and having your 18-year-old friend Kyle be your supervisor. No, supervisors have to be responsible, grown adults that can vouch for your experience. So make sure there is an imbalance of power, helping build sets for your school's play. Yes, this is a creativity and service CAS in which a responsible adult can vouch for you. Going to church with your family once a week. No, religious devotional experiences do not count as CAS. Studying for a math test every day for 1 week. No, this does not fit into any CAS strand. It is not creative, it is not an activity, and it's not a service to anyone but your grades. Going to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu practice consistently and tracking your progress. Yes, this can be a long-term CAS in which you demonstrate growth and strength and skills.
Going to the beach!
Because in this situation, you are tracking nothing and you did not plan anything.
And it doesn't help, it's not a community activity or a service.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Oh. Any comments, Vivian?
I think Vivian's a terrible host of the show.
Do your CAS.
And I think that I should replace her and get double the pay.
Now, if he was tracking his thing, it might be an activity CAS.
If he was tracking how many laps he could do in the ocean, that could be a CAS.
That could be a CAS. Playing mermaids counts as creativity.
Peeing in the ocean is not not creative.
Welcome to Give Your CAS Some Gas, the show where we find out how to turn everyday activities into CAS experiences. Feel free to pause the video if you need more time in between questions. Give your CAS some gas! You're going ice skating this weekend. How can you turn this activity into a CAS? Develop a figure skating routine for a creativity CAS. Track your ice skating, minutes, calories burned, heart rate, for an activity CAS. You were really stressed this finals week. How can we turn this into a CAS? Do yoga every night of finals week to de-stress for an activities CAS. Color in a coloring book after every test for a creativity CAS. Bake treats to give to stressed out students as a surface CAS. The student council is putting on an event. How can you turn this into a CAS? You can volunteer to either set up or clean up for a surface CAS. You can join the planning committee and discuss decor and logistics for a creativity CAS. Thank you all for playing. Give your CAS some gas!
We couldn't possibly include everything in this video, but if you have any more questions, ask your CAS supervisor. Goodbye!
Bye, guys.
Have fun with CAS.
Bye.
Not my problem anymore.
Bye.
Not my problem. Have fun, guys. We're never doing this again.
Never again.
Never again.
Bye.
We've graduated.
We're out of here. We're
you
gone.
You don't know us.
Yeah.
Bye.
See ya.
Bye.
It's CAS time. It's CAS time. It's CAS time. Whoa. I love CAS. Yeah. I love CAS. Yeah. I love CAS. I love submitting CAS. Yeah. I love CAS.